Next question. Just as hard. Probably a lot harder. Does the Bible teach there will be a great tribulation period before the end of time, before Christ returns? Turn with me to Matthew chapter 24. I'm going to answer this question very simply. I'm going to answer this question with yes and no. That's simple, right? The Bible does teach there will be a great tribulation before the return of Christ, but the Bible also teaches that tribulation has already occurred. So no. Really, the answer is no, but it's also kind of yes. If the question were, will there be a tribulation yet to come before the return of Christ, does the Bible teach that? The answer is no. Okay, but I had to change the question to answer it that way. But the Bible does teach about a great tribulation, so let's not be unclear about that. Matthew chapter 24, Jesus is about to die. He is probably within 1 or 2 days of the cross. I mean, if he dies on Thursday, it's Tuesday, or Wednesday. And I think he died on Thursday, but we don't have to get into that tonight. Matthew 24, Jesus starts talking about his return, and he starts talking about judgment. Verse 9 of Matthew 24, he says, "Then they will deliver you to tribulation." So there's your word. This word, tribulation, occurs a few times, at least 2 times in this chapter. "Then they will deliver you to tribulation and will kill you, and you will be hated by all nations because of me." So Jesus says there will be a tribulation. Come down to verse 15. "Therefore, when you see the abomination of desolation, which was spoken of through Daniel the prophet, standing in the holy place, let the reader understand that those who are in Judea must flee to the mountains. Whoever is on the housetop must not go down to get the things out that are in his house. Whoever is in the field must not turn back to get his cloak. But woe to those who are pregnant and to those who are nursing babes in those days. But pray that your flight will not be in the winter or on a Sabbath. For then there will be a great tribulation, such as has not occurred since the beginning of the world until now, nor ever will. Unless those days have been cut short, no life would have been saved, but for the sake of the elect, those days will be cut short. Then," wait a second, look at that, verse 23. "Then," okay, so there's something that's going to happen after the tribulation. The tribulation is not the end. If the tribulation were the end, it wouldn't do you any good if you're in Jerusalem to flee to the mountains. If the tribulation were the end, it wouldn't make any sense to leave everything in your house and get out quick, or not to go back to your house if you're in the field and get out quick. Jesus says, when you see the abomination of desolation, when you see the temple and the altar being desecrated, it's time to leave town. You need to go right now, because it's going to be worse than anything that has ever occurred in the history of man. And Josephus writes about it. It occurred in AD 70, and it's one of the most horrific things I have ever read about. Mothers cooking their children and eating them. It's awful. But it happened 1,940 years ago. Okay? It already happened. And you could get out. So you could flee. And that's why Jesus says, pray that it doesn't happen in the winter on the Sabbath when it's harder to travel. He says, it's going to be hard for pregnant women and nursing mothers. Well, the return of Jesus is going to be no harder on pregnant women and nursing mothers than it's going to be on every other sinner. But the tribulation. But verse 23 says, then. See, something happens after the tribulation. Then If anyone says to you, behold, here is the Christ, or there he is, do not believe it. So if anyone says, I saw the tribulation, now I see Christ, Jesus says, no. Don't believe it. It's not true. It's not true. Come down to verse 36. Jesus shifts. He was talking about the tribulation, which is the destruction of Jerusalem by the Romans. It happened in AD 70. He was talking about that, and then he shifts to talking about the end of time, where he will return and execute judgment for everybody who's ever lived. Verse 36, but of that day and hour no one knows, not even the angels of heaven nor the Son, but the Father alone. For the coming of the Son of Man will be just like the days of Noah. Okay? Jesus says, I don't know when the end is coming. Jesus says, if somebody tells you they know, they're lying. Because they don't know, the angels don't know, I don't even know. There's no tribulation that's going to key you to when it's going to happen. There's not going to be any signs. There's not going to be anything that's going to help you expect it. It's going to be unexpected. And he emphasizes this. He hammers it. Let me back up to one thing. Well, I said the tribulation has already occurred. Revelation 1, verse 9, where John is giving his introduction to the book. John, the Apostle John. Says, I, John, your brother and fellow partaker in the tribulation. John outlived the tribulation. John went through it. He lived it. And he wrote Revelation after it happened. But, back to Matthew 24, 25. Verse 42. Be on the alert, for you do not know which day your Lord is coming. Verse 44. For this reason, you also must be ready, for the Son of Man is coming at an hour when you do not think he will. You come down to Matthew 25, he tells the parable of the 10 virgins. At the end of the parable, verse 13, he says, be on the alert then, for you do not know the day nor the hour. Jesus spends paragraph after paragraph saying, be ready all the time because you won't have warning. You won't have a warning. It will come suddenly, unexpectedly. And even I don't know why. That's Jesus talking. Okay. So does the Bible teach there will be a great tribulation period before the end of time, before Christ returns? No. It teaches that one's already happened. Jesus prophesied it, but it already occurred. Doesn't mean that there won't be tribulation, but there's not one prophesied in the Bible that we can learn about our future.